Okay, this is a review for section 5.6. So in this section, you're given three specific points, and based on those points, you're being asked to find the equation. So first we start by remembering the general equation for this, right? Y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. And for the step number one, what you're gonna do is you're gonna take the values of x right here, in this case it's -2, and then you're gonna take the value of y, and you're gonna substitute into your original equation, which is this one, right, the general form. So you end up with y equals to a, and then your x is -2. Let me change this to a different color if you want to see it. So you have 2, and then this is your 2, right? And again, you add 2 on the other side. So you end up with 4a plus minus 2b. Your final equation is y equals to 4a minus 2b plus c. And then you have to equal this to 11 here, right? So this is -11 in it. And we're gonna label this as equation number one. Okay, so equation number one, you're gonna end up using in different parts here. Okay, so we'll continue to label that as we go. So you do the same thing for the next point. So now for your next point, you will have this. Okay, so you have four and 13. So you know that your x, now you're gonna substitute 4 here, you're gonna substitute 4 here, and then your y value is gonna be 13, okay? So you're gonna equal all of this to 13. So you're gonna end up with 16, because that 4 squared 16 plus 4b plus c equals to 13. Okay, so that's your this is your equation number two. For your equation number three, now you're gonna have 6 and 29. So for 6 and 29, x equals 6, so now you're gonna substitute your x in here and multiply by b as well. So you're gonna end up with 6 squared is 36, and then 36a plus 6b plus c equals to 29. So 29 is the value of your y here again, and this is your equation number three. Okay, so now we're gonna take equation one, equation two, and equation three. Okay, so this is equation one, equation two, and your equation three, in order to solve for the unknowns. Okay, so the very first step is you're gonna take equation one and equation two. Okay, so you take equation one and equation two, and you're gonna cancel one of them. So how do you choose which one to cancel? So the way that you should be looking at is cancel the one that is the simplest to cancel. In this case, c is the simplest because you can just multiply either one of them by -1, and then you can cancel one of them. But choose the one that has the lower number, so you end up with positive numbers when adding. Okay, so in this example, you can see that the one being changed is the one at the top. Okay, so this is the one that's been multiplied by -1, and this is because, you know, when you multiply, you in here, then you end up with -4a plus 2b plus c equals to 11. And then now the bottom is 16a plus 4b plus c equals 13. So you can see here that now when you add up these two, you end up with positive numbers on the bottom. You could do the other one. Either way, you still get a solution. The solution will be correct. So once you get equation A, so I'm gonna label this as equation A. So you get equation A here. You have to continue and now use, like we mentioned here in step number two, you use equation, well, I guess in this case, it would have been equation two, and equation 3. So I made a mistake here. So this should be equation 2 and equation 3. So you should have used equation 2 and equation 3. So in this case, 16a plus 4b plus c is your equation number 2, and 36a plus 6b plus c equals 29 is your equation 2. Again, same as you did in the previous step, you're gonna choose the one that has the lower numbers. Okay, so in this case, the one with lower coefficients is number 1, right? So this is the one that has lower coefficients. So I'm sorry, the one on the bottom. And when you multiply that by negative 1, you're gonna end up with this, okay? Negative 16a, negative 4b, negative c equals to negative 13. Now, you're just gonna add the equation on the bottom, okay? So 36a plus 6b plus c equals 29. From here, you can cancel, then you'll cancel c again, okay? So equation number 1, or step 1 and step 2, are used to cancel c. So you can see on step 3, you ended up now with two equations. So equation A and equation B, okay? Equation A and equation B are now 12a plus 6b equals 24. And equation B is 28 plus 2b equals 16. So in this case, you now simplify this, okay? So you know this is, so you can write in the simplest form. So in this case, it will be divided by 6. So you're gonna divide the top by 6, the equation on the top by 6, which is here, you divide it by 6, and then you end up with a simplified form of 2a plus b equals 4. And then on the bottom, you're gonna divide by 2, and then you end up with 10a plus b equals 8. From here, now you do the same step as you've done before. You have a and b in both equations, so you want to cancel, in this case, b, because it's the simplest, right? You don't need to do anything. All you have to do is now just multiply by negative 1, right? So if you multiply the top by negative 1, or you could also do the bottom. In this case, the top is the one multiply, because, again, it has the smaller coefficients, and you're going to end up with positive numbers on the bottom. So you multiply by negative, so it's negative 2a equals negative 4, and then you use add 10a plus b equals 8. So you're gonna end up canceling b, so you cancel b, and you have 8a equals 4, or a equals 1/2. Now, given this, now you move to step number 4. So now you have a. You only substitute into 12a plus 6b, which is equation a. So you substitute into equation a, and so right here this is your equation a, and then you find b. So your value of b now is 3. And the last step is to find c. So now you have a and b. You already found a and b, okay? So you need to find c. In order to find c, you use the previous values that you had already, that you already found. So you're gonna substitute your a and your b into equation 1, which is this. Or you can do whatever equation you want, but any of the equations will work. So in this case, equation 1, let's see, let me erase these things in my way. So equation 1 gives you the value of c, which is negative 7. So now you have all the values. So you have the value for a, you have the value for b, and you have the value for c. Okay. So here it is: a, your b, and your c. Okay. And all you need to do is use the general form equation, which is this. Y equals to ax squared plus bx plus c, and in this equation you are going to only substitute for a, b, and c. So a is equals to 1/2, so you get here, b equals to 3, we found here, and c equals to negative 7. So the solution is 1 half of x squared plus 3x minus 7. And once you get to this point, you're done. You're finished with the first example, okay? All right. Example number 2 is similar to the previous one, right? Example number 1 that you drew. So you're given 3 points. And based on these 3 points, you follow the same procedure. Except this one is easier because when you substitute 0.5 into your general equation, you find C right away. So knowing now, having C already being found, it just makes everything easier, right? Because you can just use it straightforward. So for point number 2, you get you have 2, 13. So the same procedure, you're gonna put 2 into your general equation, and then you're gonna find you already have C, so you already input it here. Okay, there's no need to continue without C, you already have it. So you end up, your second equation is this one. I wrote there's C as the equation 1, but it's really the value of C. And then you continue on the bottom one, and for 3.26, once you substitute the values in here, you find equation number 3. Now you're gonna use, in this case, you're gonna use the previous found equations, and with these 2 equations, you're gonna solve to find A, okay? You could also choose to find B first, but in this case, B is already the simplest one here. So you just multiply by a negative number here, and then you'll be able to add them and then cancel B. So you find A equals 3. For the very last step, you already have A, and you already have A and C, right? So using A and using C, you could substitute into any of the equations, right? In this case, we're just substituting into 2A plus B, which is equation number 2. And we substitute A, which is a 3, and then multiply 2 times 3 is 6, B, 6 plus B equals 4, and the last answer equals B equals negative 2. So for the very last step, so we use A, B, and C in order to find our solution, which is this. So you substitute A, you substitute B, and you substitute C, and this is your solution. For the very last example that they have in the book, they're actually giving you the vertex, and they're giving you 1 point, and they are saying, okay, so you have the vertex, and now I want you to find the equation again, but given the vertex and a point that is contained. Okay, so you have to keep in mind when you're solving for this, and actually for many of the problems that you're solving, you have to remember your vertex form equation. Okay, y minus k equals to a times x minus h squared. Okay, remember, whenever you find your vertex, the vertex is gonna have is gonna be in the form h and k, right? So you find your h from this section, and then you find your k from this part. Okay, so right away you can just substitute your h and k. Okay. So k is equals to negative 5, and then h is equals to 2. Okay. So you substitute, and you end up with the first equation right here. Okay. And the very next step is to use actually the point that you're given, and that point that you're given has x and y, right? X equals 3 and y equals 1. So you're gonna substitute those two values into your y and x in here. And so once you substitute, you're gonna find a, right? So this is the this is where you're gonna substitute, okay? By substituting, this is the procedure, and then you're gonna end up finding a. So once you find a, you're gonna go back into the actual equation that you started with, right? So you're gonna go back into this and just use a equals 6, put it there, and after you put it there, you're gonna end up with this, okay? So once you have that, you are being asked to write it into this form, okay? So that is the equation or the form that you have to use. So in order to do that, you continue going backwards, okay? What you've done before, use the other way around, and which is now you're gonna expand this number. And remember what I was saying? So you're gonna do the square of the first one. So it's gonna be the square of the first one plus two times negative 2 times 1 x. And then so it's gonna be plus 2 times negative, and then plus the square of the second one. So negative 2 the square equals 4. Okay. So that's how you get to this point in here. And once you get there, it's just a matter of finding the common terms. You know, you see here that negative 24 and negative 5 can be combined into 19, right? So your actual final solution is just this one here, right? There. So straightforward.